There is an adage which says that, you know, you cannot control your environment.
Yes.
You can control how you choose to react to your environment.
Absolutely.
Keeping that principle in mind, did you notice how leaders were reacting to various challenges in their environment?
Yes, and I think that one is so important because so many changes are happening today, right? The whole digital thing, technology, disruption, multi-generational workforce, teams are no more homogeneous. So all of that is happening around. Some of it you can control and most of it you can't control, right? But it's the internal control. So things like, are you making changes in your operating style? You know, are you making changes in the way you take decisions, in the way you lead teams, in the way you structure yourself? And therefore, there's this huge need for leaders to almost unlearn a lot of things, unlearn, learn, and relearn. I mean, that constant cycle is becoming so important now. And therefore, reverse mentoring is something that's picking up. It's still a new concept, but I mean, I can see that in the next couple of years, reverse mentoring is going to become so important for leaders to stay relevant.
And explain that. What is reverse mentoring?
So when we think of mentoring, we always think, oh, there's a senior guy who's been there, who's done it, who knows it all, and therefore, you know, you're going to learn from that person. Reverse mentoring is, I'm a leader, you know, I'm 44, but there's this 24-year, old team member who's really good with the whole digital stuff, understands content marketing. I know nothing about it, right? Mm-hmm. I go and talk to that person. Are you going to mentor me on how do I do my content marketing now? So learning from people who are probably less experienced in age form or maybe the number of years, but who probably know more about the subject than you do. And leaders need to open their mind to do that.
And you mentioned in the book as well that one of the things that someone can do when they are going through leader's block is look towards a mentor.
Yes.
And explain that. I mean, how does that help?
Yeah. And this is an interesting point because, like I said, mentors traditionally are the people who've been there, right?
Yeah.
Who've been there, and therefore, when you open your problem, they can look at it, you know, they can step back. So actually, mentoring does two things. One, it's talking to a person who's not involved in your drama. So who's looking at it from a third person perspective, right? You are playing two people's drama in front of that person, the person's looking from here, right? It's almost like looking at it from a balcony, as they say, right? You're looking at the problem. And therefore, he's more objective. He or she's more objective about looking at the issue. So that's the first, most important thing. When you're going through some crisis, you want somebody to look at it objectively. And mentors can do that. The fact that they've been there, they have experience, they can even identify some of those issues early on as you're telling them. And then give you even solutions of what they did or what they would possibly do. Right? Now, but sometimes even talking to somebody who doesn't have that experience, hasn't been there, can also help because they might give you a very different perspective.
Sure.
So mentoring, either which way.